Gaurangai Gagatir Vajasitamati Sigurudhamo Siti Sasai Sasatoi Gavitir Kushanga Viruti Dusto Vesaniskiti Siru Paikarati Sanatananati Sijivate Yosuti Shishidhanta Saraswati Vijayate Gauri Yogosti Pati Shishidhanta Saraswati Vijayate Gauri Yogosti Pati Gauri Yogosti Pati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, until and unless you have 100% inclination unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, you cannot speak about that absolute truth. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, until and unless you have 100% inclination unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, you cannot speak about that absolute truth. You can fear to speak about that absolute truth. If you are really 100% dedicated unto the lotus feet of that Supreme Lord, then you cannot fear anything to speak about that absolute truth. Actually, Srila Prabhupada speaking, to satisfy common people, to enjoy popularity, to satisfy common people, and to satisfy Supreme Lord, not the same. To satisfy common people, to enjoy popularity, and to satisfy Supreme Lord, to seek the satisfaction of common people, to enjoy popularity, and to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord, not the same. If I am going to seek the satisfaction of common public, it is called kama. It is called kama, my personal benefit. If anyhow I am going to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord, through Harikatha, Kirtan, Seva, anything, that is called actually Hari Seva. That is called actually Krishna Seva. Common people are so foolish, they are coming, but they cannot understand. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times, with heavy mood speaking, so many people coming here to take shelter of a guru. They are going to put tilak mala, everything. They are doing dham parikram. They are actually doing ekadasi. They are observing ekadasi, all janmashtami, rashtami, everything they are doing. They are also chanting harinam. But why they are not going to make any progress? Why they are not going to make any progress? Why? What can be the reason? Actually, the standard of bhajan, standard of harikatha, standard of kirtan, day by day, coming down, falling down. Why? Because that's why that type of sadhu is almost rare at present. That type of sadhu is almost rare at present. That doesn't mean there is no sadhu at present. We cannot say. If we are going to speak this way, there is no sadhu, then I am a guilty. I am big aparadhi. Because I am mayavadi. Omnipresent, all-powerful, almighty Supreme Lord is there. Infinity world is in a running like wind. And that Supreme Lord is unable to send some messenger here in this material world so that we can get benefit. He cannot do. He is so weak, Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord is so weak that he cannot send a right messenger, right sadhu, so that we can get some direction, indication. Go this way, nobody there? If I am going to speak this way, I would be punished heavily. One by one, I can show documents from the writings of Prabhupada and the speech of Prabhupada. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, with heavy heart speaking, they are not at all thinking about how to accept Guru, how to do Harinam, how to avoid aparadh. They have no message about that. I was speaking in Radha Kundo, maybe 12 years back. I was speaking so many times, all the time I am speaking there, but the instant I am referring, 12 years or 13 years back maybe, or 14 years, I forget. More than that. I was speaking at the bank of Radha Kundo, Kunjubihari Mod. That time I was speaking, all acharyas also there, so many, they allow Sambhava must speak. I was speaking about secret tattva of Gauriya Bhajan. Then after my speech is over, one very foolish sannyasi, number one foolish sannyasi, he want to prove always that I am a big sadhu. He print one card and say, I am the topmost speaker in the world. Idiot number one. But he is enjoying also my affection, because why? Because I am the disciple of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. Okay. In relation to Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, I am not speaking anything. If he is going to understand, have something, direct relation, he can think. Or he is going to die, he can die. What to do? After my speech is over, he wanted to break my Siddhanta. All public becomes stunned. Maharaj speaking so nice way and he is going to break. I am not speaking anything, because then outside people was not there. Only Gauriya devotees. I am familiar to them. They know very well that Maharaj speaking rightly. Anyway, after the speech is over, that sannyasi is speaking to another devotee, that Sam Baba always speaking negative way. He is speaking. Then that sannyasi was very powerful sannyasi. He respect me very much. Maharaj, come on. Somebody has to denote, indicate negative. Otherwise, how he can accept positive? Sam Baba, out of his own love and affection, he always want to project this point so that we can get steady in our bhajan. Why not? You understand? You are going to criticize, you are going to fall down. That sannyasi giving answer to him, he is speaking positive way, but you think it is negative way, because you have some anartha inside your heart, you cannot digest that harikatha, but you check up what Prabhupada told, he is speaking all same. How you can see? Oh, at all, if you want to say he is speaking negative way, okay, somebody has to show some negative point so that you can rectify yourself. Why not you thinking that way? This is the point. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times in his articles and speech speaking how to do Harinam, how to do satsanga, how to understand who is sadhu, who is not, all different characteristics, all analytical judgment. We are very lucky. We are very lucky. We are so lucky, so lucky, that we are proud that we are from Gauriya Math. Such analytical judgment, such siddhanto, finite, accurate siddhanto is not available in the infinity world. Because we are in line with Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. That is, but still we are unlucky, because we are going to lose this chance, rare opportunity. That is our intelligentsia. We are very intelligent. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, yes. Everybody think I am intelligent. He is speaking, I am also intelligent. She is speaking, I am, yes, you all intelligent. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, really, they are intelligent. But according to their own estimation, they are intelligent. But they are not actually intelligent according to the judgment of Krishna, according to the judgment of Sarup Gosai, according to the judgment of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sarup Gosai. They are not actually intelligent. They are foolish number one. So not going to make any progress in bhajan. They think we are doing bhajan. We are such a big power. Why? Who are you? Really, who I am? I have no position, rank, nothing. Who am I? Really so? I have nothing to repent. Because I have nothing to lose, nothing to gain. Because absolute gain can be arranged by my Gurudev and Guru Varga. What to speak about material gain? So I am not going to lose anything if you are going to reject me. I am not going to gain anything if you are going to accept me in your life. That's your own privilege. You can do according to your, you know, inspiration, what you are feeling inside your heart. So now Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those very accurately Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, why we cannot do Harinam, why we cannot understand who is Sadguru, who is not Sadguru, how we are going to accept Diksha from a false Guru, to get cheated from him. This way, all the time, this kind of all turmoil situation going all around the world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur now speaking, actually, why they cannot make any progress in bhajan track, simply because they are not aware about how to avoid aparadh. If they are not, you know, knowing this thing, if you have no idea about how to avoid aparadh, then some or other way, directly or indirectly, knowingly or unknowingly, all different kind of aparadh going to pull you down in your bhajan. I was speaking maybe 15, 16 years back in Ropar, Rupnagar, one city of Punjab, near Chandigarh. From Chandigarh, it is 25 kilometers. At least 15 or 16 years back, I was speaking there, I can remember. That time, I was speaking about this same thing. Why we cannot make any progress? People putting question before me. I was alone in the stage. All devotees on sannyasis sitting in a chair around me. That time I was bound to speak that we are not aware about this vital point, how to avoid aparadh. Different kind of aparadh we are doing knowingly or unknowingly. That's why we cannot make any progress in our bhajan. What to speak about progress? We are going down in bhajan. I was bound to give one example, very nice example. Even one boy of 6 years can understand this example if I speak. What is the example? In our childhood, perhaps you or many small children, they are playing one kind of plate is there, and there we have some pot in which one marking there 1, 4, 5, 6, 0 is there, that guti, that one. And we are doing this playing, if it is 6 or 4, according to that we are putting our guti, that, you know, here, there, going on. Now after that, there is also snack and ladder. Ladder, you know? Ladder. And if we are going to reach one ladder, we are very happy. Oh, Maharaj, we are going up. But on playing, gradually, when I'm going to up to 98, now just 2 if I can, you know, do, then I can reach the goal, I can get victory. But oh my God, the luck is so bad. I reach 99 where a big snake python is there. I come back to 0. Follow? This example I was bound to give there. Very nice example. Oh my God. This way, we are making progress surely. Not that your everything useless. I am not going to create some depression inside your heart. Not that. So that you can become conscious about this point, so I am speaking this way, never mind. Actually, point is that this way we are making progress, sometimes making big apparatus, you can come down. Another example I was bound to do, in my student life also, I was appearing in different exam, you know, small and a young age. That time actually, there was objective type question, follow. Objective type, you know, no? Objective type. Each question bearing one mark, follow. Each question bearing one mark. If you can, you have to put tick mark. What is okay, you have to put yes. If you are okay, then you are going to get one mark. If you are going to make mistake, then minus one. Follow. Minus one. There is hundreds. The exam, the marking is 100. Marks, full marks is 100. So you will have to answer very manually what you know. 100% you will have to answer. If you are going to answer unknowingly, then you are going to get penalty for that. This way, one very, you know, sincere boy, but he is sincere about, but he is not knowing answer, he is giving answer. After that, when the result came out, he find is zero. Well, why? Zero, why? Well, you are giving 50% answer right and 50% wrong. That's why 50 minus 50 is zero. Follow what I say? This is the topmost example. You can apply in your life to understand what is happening with you and your life. Follow. This way you will have to progress. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that those common people, they are accepting one guru, they are busy, but anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur requesting us all not to be busy, not to be busy with Guru Karan. Bhaktivinoda is thinking, wait, man, wait. You have to wait. If you are 100% sincere, today or tomorrow, Balaram Nityananda is watching you. In my life also it is 100% perfect. If you are 100% sincere, then it is the responsibility of Balaji Maharaj, Nityananda, to send one Sadguru in front of you. Not that thousands of people going there, I must take shelter. This is the situation at present. People are following blindly. I can give example from Bhagavatam. Guru Padma in one article, Vasila Bhakti Puma Purigasya Paramahansa Gurudev, in one article writing that yearly funeral cake you will have to offer, you know, at the time it is called Tarpan. At the time of Mahalaya, you know, before Durga Puja, don't know? Are you foolish? Before Mahalaya, there is one day that is called Mahalaya. That day, night time, they were all people hearing Chandi Pat. Ya devi sarva bhuteshu sakti rupena sanasthita namastasvai namastasvai is hearing. Every year you can follow. That day, it's Father's Day, you have to, Father Mane, that you are the Pitripakha. You have to give yearly cake and water to your dead relatives, father and mother, everything. Follow. You have to give. This way, actually, Guru Padma was laughing and speaking in an article. Well, it's an amazing factor. Well, one day I went to Ganga by chance that day. What to do? I will have to take bath in Ganga. And by chance there is this Tithi. So what to do? I was there. I go and see all in queue in front of Brahman. They are calling one by one, taking pranami and putting in jola and, you know, giving the star fund. Oh, you speak. This way speaking. They're offering. And actually, Brahman, he is also Brahman, but he will have to offer cake anyway. So he is coming and he has in Koshakushi one, you know, copper plate, you know, copper pot, in which urchin time we are putting like, not Panchabhatra, it is like this, like boat. He is putting it And he finds so many kosakusi there. So he thought, what to do? If I go to take bath, somebody can exchange my kosakusi. Follow my point. Very minutely you have to think. Guru Padma was speaking, that man is very intelligent. He is from an important family, very intelligent. He thought, okay, my copper, you know, this kosakusi is there. So I can do one thing. I can take some mud from Ganga and put on it so that I can identify this is my pot. I cannot get confusion. Really, so Guru Padma was watching and speaking. That man putting some soft mud on this kosakusi. He is very familiar person, important person from a high family. All common people coming, they say Mukherjee Babu putting all mud on his kosakusi. They think it is the usual rule. They all started putting mud on each kosakusi. Oh my God, after thinking, oh my God, I put some mud in my kosakusi. How in confusion, how to understand what is my? Oh my God. This is the situation. Guru Padma speaking, common people, they are so foolish. You know, lamp, you know, in hilly place, if you take the ear of one chagal, you know, goat, you pull and all the team can come, follow. This is the, in Gita also speaking, jaj acharati sestra stattat evettaro jano. This is the usual rule. So, you see, this way, Guru Padma speaking, actually, all common people, they are so foolish, they are pulling what others doing. They have no idea, no judgment, how to do, what to do. This way, they are all in confusion. They are running like mad, and they are in confusion. Same thing spoken by Prahlad Maharaj, I can speak after completing what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak. Come on, they are not at all aware about what is aparad, how to avoid aparad. Knowingly, unknowingly they are doing aparad. That's why they are in confusion. They cannot make any progress. In spite of the fact that they are following all rules and regulations, external rules and regulations, they are not looking inside heart what progress made up to today. They are not knowing. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they every day they are doing some aparad, dham aparad, nam aparad, Vaishnava aparad. This way, all the time, seva aparad, they are doing different kind of aparad. And with plus minus, suppose today getting marks 20%, minus 15, 5% extra. Tomorrow again, here five residue, with that he is doing bhajan, now going to 25%, then again making some 10% mistake, going down, minus 10, again 15%. This way plus minus going on. Follow. This way they cannot make actual progress in their bhajan. It's not possible, positive way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving so many indication with the life of his own parshada. You know, even Sachi Devi, as a Bhakti Devi, Sachi Devi, Bhakti Mata. But she is also sometimes thinking mentally that his name is Advaita. I think he is Dvaita. Dual conception is there inside him. Who told he is Advaita? Because my first son gone from home and he is arranging this so that second son can also go away. This much he was thinking someday. Bas, great aparad. Supreme Lord is there inside me. He is looking what is my intention. So he is going to guide me accordingly. So, Sachima was in great danger. How? When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to give kripa to everybody, prema. Today is a special discount I can give to everybody. Now, Ashtaprahar, everybody, Mahaprabhu showing his own, you know, Ishvara Bhava. Now, to everybody granting kripa. Everybody speaking, Prabhu, you must give Kripa to Mukunda. No! I cannot give Kripa to Mukunda. Why, Prabhu? Mukunda is so nice devotee, he's doing service, doing Kirtan all the time. Yes, but he is all the time is coming to me, coming to you all, sometime going to Sahajiya, and there also he give board. Okay, I am also with you. Follow. I am with Sambhava. I am also here with you. Very nice. This way, Mahaprabhu became very angry. But no, he is like, you know, here, Kharjatiya. Kharjatiya means? Sometime taking trina, you know, grass in teeth. Dante tina kam nidhayo padayar. Sometimes taking stick. I can beat you, idiot. This is the conception. Follow, just opposite. Mahaprabhu speaking, he is Kharjatiya. The meaning of Kharjatiya, you know? This is the meaning. Sometimes showing humble attitude. Oh, Maharaj, you are. Sometimes beating Maharaj backside. Politics. This is called Kharjatiya. Jati mean lathi. This is the condition. So Mahaprabhu speaking, I am not going to give prema to him. Prabhu, at all, I will have to think. I know. Okay, I can give 1 crore of year after I can give. Then Mukunda hearing that Mahaprabhu going to give me Kripa after 1 crore of birth. Mukunda started dancing very nicely. Mahaprabhu, why is dancing? Foolish. Well, Prabhu, you promise him that after 1 crore of birth you get. Oh, really? Then bring him. 1 crore has gone within fraction of a second because he developed that kind of belief on me. Follow my say. That day he was crying and speaking, now, can you give me 1 drop of Shraddha? Can you give me? I am ever grateful to you if you can give 1 drop of Shraddha. You cannot give me Shraddha, but you can break the Shraddha of common people, those who are coming to me. This you can do. I was speaking, now, this Siddhanta Darthe. Asakta aham griha nirmane, swaktva aham griha bhanjane. I cannot make a building. But your building is there, I can break. That is very easy for me. I can demolish this building with bomb charge, I can do. It's very easy. Follow. This I can do. As for Sanskrit literature, it is this. Ashakta aham griha nirmane. I cannot make any building. I have no money, no temperament, nothing. Well, I can break if you are going to make a nice building. I can charge bomb, big dynamite and break. That I can do. That is the situation at present. So now actually, the point is that, but I was speaking about last. Mukunda. Mukunda, that time actually, Prabhu speaking, Mukunda, you can bring Mukunda now, but you just sold 1 crore of the 1 crore year gone. Because kartum akartum anyatha kartum ya samartaha sa ishwaraha. What is the definition of Ishwar? Who can do everything? Within, you know, when Rasa Leela going on, you know the kalpakal gone. But those gopikas thinking within the fraction of second, twinkling of eyes, Rasa Leela, the enjoyment gone. So Krishna can put billions or trillions of years inside 1 fraction of second. You cannot believe. Because your material brain always say, how possible, Maharaj? How possible, Maharaj? It's possible. Krishna can put 1 trillions of billions of years, take that time period inside 1 second. Otherwise, who is Krishna? Who is going to obey Krishna? It's possible. That's why Mukunda was very aware about this thing. So Mukunda started dancing. Mahaprabhu called him. Why is dancing? Was he saying, oh, so much belief. Bring him. His 1 crore years gone. Now I can keep her. This way, Mukunda was in a position to accept prema. But Swachimata anyhow not going to get prema. Everybody requesting, but no, I cannot give Your mother, come on, your so what? She is doing aparat. Aparat? Impossible? Sachima? Yes. Ma doing aparat. Unto lotus feet of Gaurana Gosai, Advaita Gosai. Really? Yes. Whenever Advaita Gosai hearing this thing, he gone faint, fall down on ground to hear this painful message. In the meantime, Sachimata was very careful, going and touching the lotus feet of Advaita Gosai, putting on head. Gone. All aparat gone. Then Sachimata was given prema. So you see, within these two or three examples, I can speak how dangerous aparat is. Very quickly, very shortly, we'll have to all quote with different, you know, lectures of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati and writings. I point out everything, translate and give, so that nobody can misguide. This is our mission. Our mission is to stop people going to hell. Our mission is to stop people going to the wrong source. This is our mission. We are not going to make one mission to collect billions or trillions of dollars, this, that, make one big bandara for you. Not. This is our mission. If you want to join our mission, you are at liberty. You are free. You can join. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking this way, nobody can understand that what kind of mistake they are making daily, so they are not calculating, they cannot understand, that's why they cannot make any progress in bhajan. That is why in dhamma you are there, but you are doing dhamma aparad, nama aparad, you know, Vaishnava aparad, all the time you are doing everything you are doing, so you are going to miss the opportunity to reach that level. Srila Prahlada Maharaj also speaking same way as Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Those people running behind a blind people, blind man, are he is blind himself, how he can guide you? They don't know. They are only watching that lakhs of people going there, so why can go there? That's why they are going to lose even their minimum power. Dharmodhaji ganer dharma acharan baddhajib ke aro adhikotara baddha dasay loiya jay. Follow. Dharmodhaji ganer dharma acharan baddhajib ke aro adhikotara baddha dasay loiya jay. Dharma acharan, the external efficacy of a false preacher, dharmodhaji, preacher or acharya, who is holding flag. I am a pracharak, I am an acharya, but not actually that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada speaking, that kind of false acharya, his efficacy and in guidance that you are getting, that going to put you more and more and more and more and more down than at present your situation. Prabhupada speaking, dharmodhaji ganer dharma acharan, bonded soul, they are automatically in bondage, maybe 60% bondage, 80% bondage, maybe 20% bondage also they are at present. Okay, no problem. But this is the situation in which they are put into. That's why Prabhupada was speaking, dharmodhaji ganer dharma acharan baddhajib ke aro adhikotara baddha dasay loiya jay. More and more bondage they are going to put themselves down and down. What to do? So much advertisement, so much canvassing going on. Who is going to realize what is Harikatha? Who can show you that much sympathy, that much prema is where? Who can see the whole world in relation to Krishna? Can cry for me, you, my children, all my children. They are going to die. Let them save. Who is going to feel? Who is going to feel? You can show one single person. Everybody likes to reserve his own interest. If I can speak this way, automatically I can get this advantage. So you are going to die this way. Srila Prahlad Maharaj in Satyug, long ago. You are blind, so you cannot see. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Follow. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Nate vidu swartha gotimhi Vishnu dura sayaje bahirarthamani andha yathandhai rupaniyamanam teyo pisichatanta murudam nivadhya. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Nate vidu swartha gotimhi Vishnu dura sayaje bahirarthamani andhāyathandhairupaniyamānam teyo pisachatantamurudām nivādhyā. Oh my God! Hiranyakaśipu asking, hey, who guide you this way so that you are going to get some spiritual, you know, advancement? They, Prahlad Maharaj, what to speak about guidance? I cannot expect guidance from them. They are actually material. Nate vidu, they don't know. They have no information about that absolute truth. How they can give? That's why I'm asking, who giving you? Who the person? Nate vidu swartha gotim hi Vishnu. They are not aware that Vishnu, tad Vishnum paramam padam, Swada apasvanti surayo divibhu chakshuratatam. You're going to attack a Vaishnava? Any situation, they are watching the lotus feet of Vishnu, Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You cannot stop them. It's an automatic, spontaneously they are watching. Tad Vishnum paramam padam swada apasvanti surayo divibhu chakshuratatam. They are opening eyes, not that closed eyes. Open eyes, they can see Tad Vishnum Param Param Sadapashanti. Continuously, uninterrupted way, continuously they are watching. That's why they are getting power from that source. You think how he is going this power? Where from? What source that power coming? You are foolish, number one. You don't know from which source. They have aerial connection with that. Follow Supreme Divinity. That's why Prahlad Maharaj is bound to speak. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi vidu. They are not aware about their actual self-interest. They are not aware. How we can expect guidance from them? Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnum dura sayaje bahirarthamanim. What to speak about guidance? They are blind, actually. They are materially motivated. All the time they are busy with profit and loss account. So better if they go to a chartered accountant, Acharya. He is always giving loopholes. Oh my disciple, if you go this way, then you can get some benefit. Those Acharya, they are actually chartered accountant. Chartered accountant, what is the duty of chartered accountant? To show the loophole. Chartered accountant, actually, what they are doing? They are looking this way, you can pass away. You need not give payment tax to government. This is the duty, service they are doing. At least cost accountant is okay. They are giving idea, you are going to open one factory. This way if you apportion it all expenses, this way your product, you are going to make some, soap or something, medicine. This way all expenses he can calculate this way. He can speak. Your all product, each product should be price, if 25 rupees is okay. If you are going to put 25 rupees for each, product in market you can sell, then the profit is sufficient for you. Because cost accountant is thinking so much, you are using this machinery na, for production. You are foolish, you are going to use it, the machine. But cost accountants is giving this idea, Maharaj, someday that machine can go out of order. So you will have to calculate, put some money in this account. It is called depreciation account. Depreciation. All machinery parts going depreciate, you have to put this amount separately. So when machinery parts going out of order, you have to take this amount from this source. So fine. This way, if you are going through economics, then you can understand. delegation of authority coming from up, director is there giving order to the, you know, next. Then all chairman, all, you know, foreman, these are labor, all delegation authority. I mean, authority coming down, channelized and divided so that the whole organization, I mean, this factory can get full action. Follow? So, this kind of people, false acharya, can show you the way through which you can get some benefit, material benefit. But a real acharya can slap you, beat you. You are going to agitate against, pushing agitation, nite habe, mante habe. You say in India, there is so much agitation, political agitation. Mante habe, dite habe, we have to buy it. It's Ganatantra, you know? Democracy, autocracy. They are speaking this way. They are speaking. This way, no question of any agitation. In front of Sadguru, if you are going to make any agitation, you have to get lost. I can give example. Very. So, actually, agitation you are going to do, then you are going to lose. But we know it very well. That maybe sometimes some rules and regulation can be amended, amendment can be done therein, therein Sangsad. Sangsad, you know, parliament. Follow, some rules and regulation they are prevailing at present, they can amendment it and change it. Follow, change it. Some rules and regulation they can amend. Amendment can be done, follow, in parliament. By boat. But this kind of amendment is not possible, foolish number one. This kind of amendment is not possible in the spiritual world. You think it is also possible here? This kind of amendment is not at all possible in this bhajan life. No amendment. Once done, once spoken by one Guru Vaishnav, pure Guru Vaishnav, it's okay. But those who are not pure Guru Vaishnav, I can show you hundreds of mistakes you bring me. I'm not going to fight with them. I can show you. What Siddhanta spoken by Prabhupada, what Siddhanta spoken by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what Siddhanta spoken by Vishwanath Chakravarti, by Jiva Goswami, what they are speaking. Follow what I say. This way, all the time you have to be very careful. Otherwise you are going to lose your bhajan. So, any Siddhanta given by Rupa Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, nowadays it is not Maharaj possible, obsolete, you will have to change it. No! You cannot speak that way, it's not possible. Great offense. Those who wanted to amend some restriction, rules and regulation of Prabhupada, all they gone. All they gone in hell. All they gone. One time putting agitation against Prabhupada, all gone. They are not a disciple of Prabhupada. They are going against Prabhupada. All the time they are against. They are not disciple of Prabhupada. 100% Siddhanta. Now actually, Prahlad Maharaj, I can give example also. I can give example, but I cannot speak the name because it is not my mood to criticize somebody. Because they are all my Shiksha Guru, directly or indirectly, positively or negatively, they are showing me. See the consequence. See the consequence. Be careful. You will have to meet. Be careful. So they are all my Shiksha Guru, maybe negative or positive way, directly or indirectly. So I think they are all my Shiksha Guru. Okay. Somebody going to protest against Prabhupada according against the strict Siddhanta, gone. Big famous Gauriya editor. Somebody can speak, Maharaj, Prabhupada himself announcing in front of public that today Gauriya editor going to speak in front of you. Carefully you go on hearing. Why? Because he is enjoying full kipa Prabhupada. Follow. Maybe not full kipa, maybe 0.001% less kipa, then 100%. Follow. Maybe 0.001% deficiency there. But that person, how possible everybody is sitting with diary and pen. Pen and pencil, they are, you know, sitting to note what Gaudiya editor speaking. After the speech is over, Prabhupada speaking. You will have to come hundreds of time to speak about this absolute truth, absolute way, in front of our public. This way Prabhupada says. But if I have no pot, how I can accept? If I think, oh, Prabhupada going to, you know, giving me honor this way, so what a pig, Hanuman, monkey I am. My, you know, tail is very good, very big, you know. In front of Ravan, Ravan was very puffed up. Ravan sitting in Singhasan, Hanuman is down. After Hanuman thought, I must give some lesson to him. So Hanumanji Maharaj thought he is actually idiot. He actually foolish number one, Rakshas. Why should he sit up in front of me? I am actually Ramdas. Say then Hanumanji Maharaj started increasing his tail and making more and more high. Then Ravan looking, hey, what you are doing? Up, follow. Hanumanji Maharaj sitting in up. This way, Prabhupada speaking, that Krishna Bhakta Saitan is Saitan. Krishna Bhakta is Saitan of Saitan. Follow? Don't understand. Foolish number one. That's why. Krishna Bhakta Saitan is Saitan. Those who are Saitan, those who are miscreants, those who are very wicked, for them, Guru Vaishnava appear in the form of a master, so that I am more than you. If you are going to learn Bengali, I can speak in crude language, Bengali. But now I cannot. I cannot speak. Sherer upor swase, those who are hearing this English language, they can understand. Sherer upor swase rache, sher, you know, that on those person, previous day, previous on those ancient days, there was a one measuring instrument, sher, mane 1 kg not actually, little less than, one measuring instrument. So if you sow one sher, I can sow more than one sher in front of you. This is Guru Vaishnava. One day Prabhupada putting in a gate, no entry. Then all devotees say, no entry, but Prabhupada laughing and speaking. Actually, those outside people, puffed up people, those things, vanity, full, you know, false ego, from there, in front of them, we will have to write this way, no entry. Otherwise, they can think a very cheap sadhu there inside, we can insert. Prabhupada speaking this way. I learned it all from Prabhupada, this way. We must be very humble from heart, but outside, you'll have to give some treatment. Hey, who are you? Follow, because we are going to represent Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. If we are foolish, we cannot represent him. The smartest spiritual leader in the world, infinity world. His name is Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, be careful. Nobody can compare with Prabhupada. That name is Prabhupada. So this way, actually, Prabhupada giving us lesson all every time. One day, they think Prabhupada giving us so honor, so we are big Hanuman, monkey. Then they are going to lose Kripa gradually. Down and down, down, bas, all Kripa gone, fall down with a woman, marry, all massacre, leave Prabhupada, gone to some other spiritual leader to take Diksha, all fall down. This is the case. So any moment when Gurudev want to project me in front of public is my disciple, you see, giving power. If I think, oh, my Gurudev, who is Gurudev? I have heard in our temple, who is Gurudev? I'm not going to speak the name. Who going to know Gurudev? I am the person who announce in front of public that this is my Gurudev Paramahansa. Otherwise, who is going to? I say, oh my God, he's Mayavadi. Number one Mayavadi, everybody is following him. Okay, let him die. Let them know what to do. I cannot fight. This is a situation. Through Siddhanta, Vichar and Acharan, you can arrest your Mayavadi. Those who are intelligent, those who are real devotee, they understand. You will have to get established in Acharan, Acharadarsa, otherwise you cannot. This way, all they get lost in bhajan life. They dishonor Prabhupada. When they are writing so many books, not even speaking about Prabhupada. Nothing. Then Paramahansa Kesab Goswami Maharaj speaking, he is going to fight against Gaudiya Math. He is actually a demon. He is writing three books through which it's one kind of trident. He want to attract Gaudiya devotees and Gaudiya Math. But Gaudiya Math is not a cheap organization like your organization that you can kill with cheap philosophy and misinformation. Be careful about that. You can die, you can burn up. Be careful. So this way you see, they are writing so many things. Kesab Goswami Maharaj speaking. I love Kesab Goswami Maharaj. I am the disciple of Kesab Goswami Maharaj. That kind of power is there. He is putting protest note. At present, nobody putting protest note. Kesab Goswami Maharaj speaking. We are less interested about what is written there in the book. First of all, we like to know who is this Gurudev. Subodh Babu, who is this Gurudev? First, let us know. After that, we can read the book. First of all, let us know, who is this Gurudev? How dare he going to leave Prabhupada and, you know, all about Harinam, these, all misinformation, like Sahaja. All people going through this. How I can protect? Prabhupada knowing everything. Now you can put, Maharaj, Prabhupada told Ganesh, Prabhupada giving this title, Ganesh, okay. That doesn't mean he is Ganesh. That means Prabhupada blessing him so that he can become very conscious, sincere, and regarding quality, he can become like that. Whenever Guru Pātta was praising, Prabhupada speaking, we are really unlucky when we are going to hear some praise. Guru Pāda Padma glorifying my name. Oh my God! Prabhupada speaking, nobody can speak. Prabhupada speaking, that is very, we are very unlucky. When Gurudev going to glorify my name, stop and go away. Stop and go away. Don't hear. That is a very bad day. We are going to cheat me, Gurudev. One day, Prabhupada speaking Harikatha there. Where? Navadip, that side. Rani Chada. Repeatedly, they are requesting, Bimalapasha, you can come and okay, please come. Please come that time, Bimalapasha. Prabhupada gone, what to do in speaking Harikatha? Like fire. And while speaking Harikatha, Prabhupada speaking, my Guru Pāda Padma Paramahansa Sesto, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj is the idealism in the life. This way glorifying Gurudev. And by chance, Gaur Kishore Baba was there sitting in the audience to hear his Gurudev, Prabhupada. Who is Gurudev? Prabhupada Gurudev or Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj Gurudev? See the mood of a Sadguru. Be careful. He's speaking. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj sitting in mud to hear the lecture of his Prabhu. We think he is disciple, Prabhupada's disciple. But Gaur Kishore Babaji is speaking, Amar Prabhu, my Gurudev. When Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj hearing that my Prabhu going to glorify my name with Kambal. Kambal was a winter time Kambal, he gone. When going away, Prabhupada saying, hey, my Guru Pāda Padma here, hearing Harikatha in there, in audience, oh my God. Prabhupada was crying, oh. This is the humble attitude of a Vaishnava. This is the humble attitude of a Vaishnav. Vaishnav can never say, I am topmost. I am the topmost preacher. Never speak like that. Vaishnav never speak like that. Never, not possible. His heart cannot permit. The more we get Guru Kripa, the more we like to go down and down. We want to become, down and down means we want to become humbler than the blade of grass. That is the mood. Just opposite mood can throw you away from bhajan forever. Whenever Gurudev going to glorify my name, all people coming to give garland to me, that time must be very careful. Everybody going to worship me, I must be very careful. That is a black day for me. I can grow false ego. Ami to Vaishnav, e buddhi hoile, amani na hava ami. Ami to Vaishnav, I am Vaishnav. If this kind of mood going to touch me, then I can become fall down. Nijo sheshto dane, uchishto adi dane, hobe obhimano bhar, in Bengali Bhakti Mantra. I am elevated, so I can give my uchishto. Hey, take prasadam. Then, what is the condition of those who are going to take prasadam, uchishto from him? You hear from Prabhupada. Try to project it in front of public, so that nobody can misguide them. Prabhupada speaking this way. Prabhupada speaking. Come on, Prabhupada speaking. You see the mood, Bhakti Mohan Thakur writing this way. That, Prabhupada speaking. What to speak about giving uchishto, taking uchishto from him? Prabhupada speaking, the meaning. What to speak about giving uchishto? He is giving uchishto to others. Those common people, if going to give their uchishto to them, still they can fall down. Follow, you see? You cannot understand. Your brain cannot go up to that far. Follow what I say. Prabhupada speaking, he is distributing his uchishto to everybody. What to speak about taking uchishto from him? If this common man going to give uchishto, I mean common devotee, going to give uchishto to him, then he can again fall down more. You see the mood of Prabhupada. How accurately Prabhupada speaking. Whole world can go against Prabhupada. They cannot tolerate because they have some weakness inside their heart. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Andha yathandhi rupaniya manam teyopi sichatanda murudam nivadya. Are they themselves are blind. How they can guide you, Maharaj? They are blind themselves. They don't know the ultimate goal of life is Vishnu Charan. They are always thinking about material benefit. They are busy with profit and loss account. How they can guide you? How they can show you the way to reach that absolute truth? Impossible or next to impossible. Hear me, I can write in note, diary and signature under the guidance of Prabhupada. Not possible. Let them die. Thousands of people die. What to do? Follow? This kind of slow poison is already there, pushing. Like Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Nagasaki there. There you can remember, Hiroshima, Nagasaki. One bomb was charged, atom bomb. Still today, those poor people, they are giving birth to children, those who are having no leg, no eyes, they cannot speak. You are that kind of, you know, dangerous demon. You are going to put slow poison in such a way, ultimately whole devotional line can get destroyed. This much you can do. You cannot give the nourishment to the teachings of Prabhupada. You cannot give the nourishment to the teachings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You cannot give the ultimate teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That you cannot do. You can do this much, you can misguide people. So that can grow, you know, aparat, day by day, they can do aparat, you yourself can go to hell forever, you can take all of your followers into hell. This much you can do, you are very expert. I can give two examples, one example. Again I can come back to the slope. In front of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, one day, Srila Goswami Maharaj, Aprakita Prabhu, and Hayagri Brahmachari, Hayagri Prabhu, these two, they are called Lakshmi of Gaudiya Math. They are doing collection everywhere and running. But actually, Prabhupada running Gaudiya Math. They could realize someday. One day they come, they approaching Prabhupada and speaking, Prabhupada, actually we cannot hand over all this collection to that in charge of the mort. We can give it to you. Prabhupada, why? Because we are not satisfied, he is misusing something. Prabhupada speaking, it was my standing order to give to him. You have to follow. Now we are doing so much energy giving and after that we are okay. But it was my instruction to you to give to that in charge. What he is doing, that is my lookout. Follow? Then next day they are going for bhiksha. Whole day they are running, not getting any bhiksha. Not getting any bhiksha. After they coming back to Prabhupada with crying mood. Prabhupada laughing. You are going for bhiksha? You are going for preaching? You think you are going for preaching? You are a great preacher? That is your defect? That is why you are going to fall down? You don't know. Sadguru giving power, Prabhupada giving power. You don't know. That is the main defect with you. That's why you cannot make any spiritual progress. One day when Prabhupada speaking, that they are manipulating money. They are so much donation we give. So we cannot stay in Gaudiya Math. We cannot stay here. We like to take leave from you, Prabhupada. Some devotees speaking. Those who are collection doing. Madhukori Vaksha. Prabhupada looking at them. I know. But what is the problem with you? I know, but what is the problem with you? They say they are misusing money. I have my eyes, I can see everything. A tattvajnani mahapurush can see everything, can see your heart, everything they can look. Follow, they can see everything, a tattvajnani purush. So who are speaking? What is the problem you are facing? Let them do whatever they are doing. What is concern to you? Is there any problem with your bhajan? Then they stop thinking. Really so? They can make mistake. We can also make mistake. How we can leave Prabhupada? Impossible in infinity period. This is the golden opportunity. Golden opportunity. This is the top most golden opportunity we are getting. We are getting Prabhupada. I am getting Prabhupada as my Param Guru. I am a small creature. You cannot find my infinity in this infinity universe. That much identity I don't have. I am not even a creature, insect. But still that much privilege I have. I am going to enjoy, keep up. Bhakti Pamat Puri Goswami. Niskapat! Paramahansa Sesto, I can touch Vaisasana, speak loudly. Bhakti Pamat Puri Goswami, Paramahansa, topmost Paramahansa. That much proud I have. No, I know I cannot do bhajan, but this much I can say, my Gurudev is topmost, Paramahansa. This much I have my pavilion. Bhakti Vita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa. Bhakti Rakha Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa. Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Paramahansa. We are in this race, so lucky. Who is going to accept an insect like me? They are so merciful, they accept me. This much I can say. This way, that day, they stop thinking, what Prabhupada speaking, really so? What it concern to her? Sadguru knowing everything, who is doing woman association, who is doing what? Prabhupada can see. Prabhupada also can see what I am doing. Prabhupada can also arrest me, I am cheater or not. Prabhupada can do. Everything can Prabhupada speak. Everything can Prabhupada watch. So why I am going to bother about this point? This way you see, Prahlad Maharaj long ago speaking this philosophy. Hare Maharaj, like a blind man, near blind man, you are going, all blind, one blind guided by another blind. How? What can be the result? One blind is guided by another blind. This is the condition. Andha yathande rupamiya manam teo pisichatanta murudamni vadya. Urudamni. Dam mean? Namaste sudamne spurodipti damne. You know, Damodalila? You don't know what is dam mean? Dam mean? Rope, foolish. Rope. You know, so they are tightly bonded by Maya. They are tightly bonded by Maya. So how they can guide you? You are falling behind them. Okay, you die. Now is the age of advertisement. Now is the age of canvassment, canvassing done. Canvassing is totally different. Canvassing means a medicine canvasser or some cheap article in train on bus, in street, somebody, this is price only 25 rupees. It's very nice. You can take this product. You can get benefit. This way speaking. It's called trade hike. Follow. My product is very good. You can take kindly. It's called trade hike. It is called. It's called actually. Also, Prabhupada speaking. Somebody is there. They are platform speaker. They have no spiritual background. Or at all, they previously got some spiritual background that they lost due to aparad. They lost aparad. It's called canvassing. Canvassing is totally different from bhakti preaching. Canvassing is totally different. Come on, man, be careful. Canvassing is totally different from actual preaching, Harikatha. I can show one by one example through which you can understand. Harikatha means to melt the heart of others. Harikatha was done by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Harikatha was done by Prabhupada. Harikatha was done by Srinivasa Acharya. Harikatha was done by Narottama Thakur. Harikatha was done by Samananda Prabhu. I can show thousands of examples. The moment they are opening their mouth, all the surrounding, they get melted. They get melted. Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj and, you know, Bhakti Vidya Madhavi, they are singing kirtan in front of Jagannath. Somebody going to pickpocket, you know, take money from the jola. Somebody shouting, somewhere, Maharaj, that man going to do pickpocket, actually, money. Guru Maharaj become very angry. Foolish, number one. Why you are going to speak this point? Why? But I'm going to lose my point. I'm enjoying so much with Jagannath. You are breaking this? Foolish. What money, position, what can do? What I can do with that? Money can come, money can come. Today you are going to insult me, tomorrow you can honor me. That is a condition of this material world. Let them insult me. I want openly, let them insult me. Let them insult, I want insultment. Let them insult. I like to get power more and more. Prabhupada speaking, not I am speaking. Let material people come and kick on my head. So that I can grow more and more humble attitude. This much I can do. Guru Padma was niskinchan, penniless. Penniless. But still, he was full of treasure. Those who are blind people, they couldn't see that he is a proprietor of immense treasure he has in heart. Be careful. So this way, andha yathandhe rupaniya manam teya pisichatanta murudam nivadhyā. Urudam nivadhyā means tight rope bandage there in hand and leg. They cannot move. At the same time, they are also blind. How you are going to follow them to get right direction? How? This is the condition. Prahlad Maharaj speaking and crying in front of Nishingadev. Andha yathandi rupaniya manam. Teyapi suchatanta murudam nivad. At present, this is the condition of the world. If you are lucky enough, 100% lucky, then you can get the rare and rare, rarest of the rare chance to go through this message but given by Prabhupada. We are all messenger. We are all messenger. We are going to distribute message what I got from Guru Bhargava. Message from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Guru Bhargava, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This much we can say. Nothing to do. This way actually, day by day, we have to understand the mood of Prabhupada. Prabhupada is never upset to them. Prabhupada used to give them big honor. At present, they are going to leave Prabhupada. They are going to dishonor Prabhupada. They are going to insult Prabhupada. They are going to write all wrong Siddhanta against Gauriya Math. Still Prabhupada not speaking anything. Let them do. Their luck is so bad. They are so ill luck. Their luck is so bad. They are going deviated from the track of Sadguru. They are going to open one new club. Saturday club. They are going to open one Saturday club and Sunday club. They are not going to open any spiritual organization. If at all spiritual organization, their spiritual activity must be there. Can you prove? If at all in spiritual organization, you will have to prove their spiritual activity going on. What is the net outcome? That is the question Krishna speaking now. What Krishna speaking? There are all different kind of activities going on. But you will have to calculate what is the net outcome you are going to get. What is the net outcome you are going to be able to calculate? Otherwise, all your activities false. Follow. You have to calculate what benefit you are going to get out of this. You are participating in Harikatha. You are participating in Parikram. Okay, you can do. After that, you will have to calculate. No. What is the net achievement you are going to get out of that? Anyhow, all these procedures are kept by Guru Bhargava to get real Sadhu Sangha. And that real Sadhu Sangha you want to kick. You need not do Sadhu Sangha. You are going to kick. Then, all other procedure, the skeleton, no life, all parikram, all everything, what for, what is the reason? What is the reason? When all devotees is going to take permission from Prabhupada, Prabhupada, give us permission. Now, Brajamandal, Gaur Mandal, Gaur Dham Parikram is over. We are going to go back to our home. Prabhupada sitting in Vyasasana and crying. They are taking permission. Prabhupada permits us. Prabhupada cannot speak anything. Only crying. Cannot speak even a single word. Because Prabhupada crying, why? So mercy. He's crying for all common people. At least for 6 days, 7 days, they have the privilege to take prasadam. Stay with Sadhu Sangha, Kirtan, Dham Parikram. Now they are again to jump into fire. How I can give them permission? Cannot give permission. This way, merciful incarnation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Prabhupada crying. All our Guru Bhargava life, Bhakti Vidya Madhava Goswami, Maya Bhakti Pama Puri Goswami, all the genius, jewel, they are paramahansa. I cannot insult them. Even a false information about him can take me into hell forever. I cannot get out of that. One day, in front of Bhakti to Madhava Goswami, everybody coming and, you know, putting some objection. Maharaj, why you are keeping him in mud? He's so angry all the time. He is, you know, so angry, fighting with... That man is so angry, if you speak something, and he was Assami, so angry. If you speak something, if he cannot attack with cutter, he can go to garden and take the cutter and start cutting banana trees. Cut, cut, cut. To neutralize the mood. Follow. Because now he's very angry. He's taking the corner. Cut, cut, he's cutting. Because at least where to put this angry attitude? There? Banana tree at least cannot speak anything. Why you are cutting me? Follow, you see. This, now after that, everybody putting... Then, actually, everybody speaking like that. Madhava Goswami is calling that devotee. Come. Why you are giving pain to all these devotees? Unnecessary you are giving. Why you are so angry? Better you go back to home. Better you can go back to home. This speech, Madhava Goswami cannot speak. He breaks down in tears. How I can put this man and throw him to fire? You see the merciful attitude of a Vaishnava. You see, if you have any kind of, you know, consciousness, you can understand. Madhava Goswami cannot speak. He's bound to speak with Vaishnava speaking. Better you can go back to home. Cannot speak. He break down into tears. Crying and crying, how I can speak that you can go back to home? How I can put this jivatma and throw into fire? Oh. One day, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj was there in Calcutta Mutt. One devotee without information from Chagda Mutt coming to Calcutta Mutt. Almost 10 o'clock. And by chance, Madhava Goswami Maharaj Harikatha finished, and after that, prasadam arrangement going on, Maharaj talking with him. Maharaj watching that devotee coming. Hey! Kota teke ascho, where from you are coming? Maharaj from Chagda Goriam, Chagda Matan. Why? Who sending you? Nobody. Then why you are coming? You have any letter? You have any urgency? That's why you are coming? Well, no. Go back. Go back. I cannot allow you to stay in Mat. Go back. Then the boy with luggage going outside, and Madhava Goswami started crying. How I am merciless, I am speaking that boy to go away from temple, 10 o'clock over, how he can reach host. Bring him back, bring him back, bring him back. You see the merciful attitude of. This is called Bhakti to Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He cannot bear the pain of any god brother who is developing so much disease. It's impossible to cure. Madhava Goswami bring him from home, keep him in temple, arranging milk, cheese, everything, medicine. Oh God brother, I am there. Don't think. You get treatment here. You need not do anything. Giving treatment. Whole day and night, Madhava Goswami speaking, hey! Be careful about my God brother. Be careful, he is sick. He should get back his health. Be careful, always give service to him. Giving this service. After that, when he become Acharya, he is going to kick on the head of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. This is called Vaishnavism. Follow, you see? How great Vaishnav they are. I cannot pay to Bhakti to Madhava Goswami Maharaj. I cannot pay to Bhakti Ballabhtitya Goswami Maharaj. I cannot pay to Chaitanya Gauriya Math. I cannot pay. But long time, most of the time, I need to go to Calcutta to do press seva or this seva, that's always I am staying in Chaitanya Gauriya Math, Calcutta, taking their prasadam. How I can forget the lotus feet of Madhava Goswami Maharaj? How I can forget the lotus feet of Bhakti Ballabhtitya Goswami Maharaj? How much kripa I enjoy from them, I cannot forget. I am not a jackal, a dog. It is not possible for me to forget. So long I am living, I can speak about Bhakti with Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Even after next life, I cannot forget. This Sriti remembrance can come and touch my heart. My heart can get melted. So, at least I am not, you cannot expect that I am not grateful. You cannot speak this way. At least I know I have no quality. But at least I have no gratefulness, you cannot say. That way. It is there. So this way all Guru Vaishnav, I can speak one by one history. One devotee, not devotee, common boy, of actually 22 years of age, coming from Krishnanagar next station. He is suffering heavy disease. First one is Madhava Goswami Maharaj, that was tuberculosis, TB disease. And second one, this I am speaking about Progyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. He is suffering from lack of birja, no? All the young men, they have their power, that vitals of body going away. And almost a cripple is going to die. Every day he is losing vitals of the body. How you can understand a sadhu is so powerful, brahmacharya? If you look at him, you can see, so shining, as if like magnet catching me. Then you can understand, he is following actual brahmacharya. Follow? There is a symptom. You are foolish, you cannot understand. Then he is coming to temple. He is lying in gate side. Everybody, hey, where from you are coming? I am coming from that place. Nadia, what do you want? I want to stay here in temple. What you can do? You are sick. I need prasadam. I am very hungry. Ha! Go. And out of that, some devotee is very merciful. Maybe my Gurudev going to look him, all problem can be solved. Merciful glance of Gurudev. You can do one thing. You go there and lie down there. Outside the Bhajan Kutir of our Gurudev, Bhakti to Madhava Goswami, what they can do, you stay there. Don't speak anything. Go. Then in the meantime, sometime, Kesava Goswami opening door. Hey, why, who you are? Maharaj crying. My disease is there, I cannot move. What happens? Maharaj can understand. Okay. We can give treatment to you. You like to stay in Gauri? Yes, my family member, their father, mother, and father is not there. Or my brother, they kick me out. I cannot stay. Okay, you can stay temple? You can stay? Okay. Yes, I like to stay. You stay? We can give you treatment and prasadam, and gradually you can grow. Then really so, that Kesava Goswami, who is, you know, in front of you, is lion. So merciful, like more than mother. Billions of mother one side, and the mercy of one Guru Vaishnav, you cannot compare. If you are going to compare, then you are idiot number one. Then really so. That sannyasi is there in Vrindavan. He respects me very much. He's there, I don't like to name. He's there. He is now sannyasi, doing bhajan in Barsana here. See the miracles. He is supposed to die, he is going to die. But the kripa-dishti, the merciful glance of a Guru Vaishnav can protect you from hell even. And that Guru Vaishnav you are going to insult. Where you can get place? In hell? Not even in hell. Down and down, more than hell. You have to be careful. Be careful, more and more. Punishment you can get. We should not speak this way. So, why Prabhupada crying? Simply because those devotees going away, leaving me. At least they have the privilege, 6 days they are staying in Chaitanya Mahat, doing Parikram, they are hearing Harikatha, doing chanting. At least they are, you know, oh my God. They are going to take permission from me to go back to home to jump into fire. Like, you know, those insects having some wing, you know, in before Kali Puja, there's insect, they're flying in front of lights, you know, and fire. They know that we are going to die, burn up our pan. Still, they cannot stop jumping into fire. That is the case with you. That is the case with you. That's why you are very interested to do Guru Vaishnava Aparad. That is the reason for why you are doing Guru Vaishnava Aparad. Otherwise, how you dare to do Guru Vaishnava Aparad? What Prabhupada speaking, I can choose one writings of Prabhupada. I can select all the writings very quickly. Try to engage thousands of people to do this seva. We can give all our pranami for this seva. We don't need. Bread can come by the mercy of. We are not going to pray in front of Supreme Lord that, oh, way, oh, Supreme Lord, give us daily bread like Christian people. We are not. We are less interested. We know Supreme Lord can give. Automatically. Why we can go? We are cheap. Eh? Oh, God, give us daily bread. Hey, foolish. God is creating this world. They can give automatically. What it concerns? Huh? He is going to give you. You have to be sincere about bhajan, about money, about sija. How I can go? I know myself. I know my in Vyasasan. I am not speaking lie. I was almost penniless. That time I was doing bhajan. I cannot do bhajan, but I was trying to do bhajan. This much, this I cannot express this kind of mood. One day I was supposed to come to Calcutta. I mean, Navadvip Dham. I have no money, nothing. How to go? No chappal even. No chappal. Only one karam I got, I am using. I am inside, I am taking darshan of Govindadev, everything. I am thinking, not praying in front of Supreme Lord. Only I am thinking, with karam I can, how I can go? At least one sandal should be there. But I cannot ask from anybody. Mentally I am thinking. I pay dandavat to Govinda. Come outside, one devotee paying Dandavata, Maharaj, Dandavata, I am so lucky, take darshan of you. Why? He is hearing Harikatha, fire from my mouth. Luckily, she is there to take darshan. After that, I am speaking some Harikatha. I am going out of the temple. Maharaj, you are with karam. Karam is not good, actually. Vrindavan, up and down, you can break your. So, you take some money, you give to. One devotee which was there, hey, you buy one sandal from Maharaj, give money to him. I was about to cry. Oh Prabhu, I never asked you to give me one chambal, chapal. I never asked you. How you arrange? With a chapal, I come here. Many times such thing happens. When I was there in Gokul, Mahavan, almost forest, there one day I am going to do, I was interested to do Govardhan Parikrama. How to go? No money. At least bus, they can ask money. I was thinking. Then one Brajamataji, coming, Baba, where you are going? Mataji, I like to do Govardhan Parikrama. Dham Parikrama. That's why I am going. You have money with you? Fair? I keep silence. I don't speak. She understands. She run to home, bring some money, give. One day in Bandaval, deep, strong cold, 8 degrees. In Vrindavan, I witnessed 4 degrees or even come down. I have no chapal, with barefooted I am going for bhiksha, chapati from Brahman house. One lali means like your age. Baba, where you are going? Madhukuri lali, you have no chapal? You are going where? It's too much cold. I keep silence. She ran to market noontime and bring one chapal. This way Krishna helping everything to me. Why I am going to beg from you? That give me this, that. Actually, I have no deficiency, no shortage inside my heart. Actual shortage is there inside heart. If at all any shortage can be there. Because Krishna can arrange everything. What is the mood of a real sadhu? I am going to one by one example. After that, tomorrow I can speak the mood of Prabhupada, what Prabhupada wanted to give instruction, wanted to. Bhakti Vedanta Bhamangosi Maharaj, one example in our Gauriya society, one example of Guru Seva. It's one remarkable example of Guru Seva is Srila Bhakti Vedanta Bhamangosi Maharaj. Each and every time I'm glorifying His name. Follow? You see the tolerance. You see the Trinadapi. All devotees in front of Him, they are feeling very nice. Those who are non-devotee, jealous, feeling envious with Him, always trying to do some mistake. Criticize Maharaj. Maharaj is very happy. He's unnecessarily criticizing. We say Bhaman Goswami Maharaj is a dictionary of Gauriya mot, Gauriya society. Dictionary. He can speak everything. That year, that time, my Gurudev speak the Bhaktivita Madhava Goswami speak the this, that, all memory. We speak. Follow. All the Harikathas of Keshav Goswami Maharaj and Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, most of those in Bengali and Hindi, you can go if you understand, you can cry. Even the disciple of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, I was there. He was the actual disciple of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. That day I was speaking in Bengali. But if you hear that Harikatha, you think I am glorifying on Gurudev. Because I know he is actual sadhu. I am not a cheater. When I can feel he is actual sadhu, his name is Govinda Maharaj. His name is Govinda Maharaj. When Bhaman Govinda leak body, then he is speaking, my Gurudev gone, I can also, I cannot stay here. Follow Govinda Maharaj. Externally you can find he is mad. He said, my Gurudev gone, I cannot stay here anymore. Within 2 days he is going to leave body. My Gurudev gone, I can also leave body. This is Guru Sevak. So I was impressed to speak Harikatha in his disappearance way. People started crying. I was also full of tears. You can think I am glorifying my Gurudev. You cannot say Maharaj always criticizing. You cannot speak that way. You will have to follow me. When and how I am speaking. Otherwise you can make a great mistake. Follow. That day Harikatha, if you someday if you learn Bengali, you can grow. Siliguri, there, Melon Palli. Now that Bhaman Goswami Maharaj understand who is my disciple, who is not. That Keshav Goswami Maharaj understand who is disciple, who is not. Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj understand who is my disciple. Narottama Prabhu, this Kamakha Prabhu, his name was Kamakha previously. Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Santa Goswami Maharaj also know. When somebody is speaking, you are getting so much disciple. Maharaj same, I am getting only one actual disciple in my life. Who is speaking? Santa Goswami Maharaj. Actually, I get one genuine. What a Gurudev can do for a genuine devotee, you cannot even imagine. Even in dream, you cannot think. Govinda Maharaj, before going, a disciple of Bhaman Goswami, he is giving all the account of ornaments of and money deposited all to somebody, devotee. You take. I am going to leave my body. Leave body. And another day, that devotee who is going to give account, you know, account of Govinda Maharaj also. This Govinda Maharaj giving account. And that devotee from Kharagpur, he is the disciple of whom? Santa Goswami Maharaj. He was supposed to go to hospital for operation by writing a big letter. Gurudev, painful history, writing, maybe I cannot come back, so I give you account where I keep this money. I keep this money with that devotee. I keep this money in bank. This ornament, here, they all accounts. All. I am going now to hospital. Then letter was there with Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj. Santa Goswami reading this letter and crying. Immediately next day, information coming that Sagar Goswami Maharaj is no more. he left body. Operation was not successful. Like child started crying, like one child. Like one child, Santa Goswami started crying like child. You cannot stop him. Like child. And whole life, so long he was there in the world, he used to keep the photo of his disciple, Sagar Maharaj, in front of his bed. Every morning, looking his face. Can you imagine what is the relationship between disciple and Gurudev? You cannot even imagine. So much philosophy you can memorize. But I am speaking from my direct realization. I am not making any false philosophy in front of you. Be careful. I am not going to speak any cheap philosophy in front of you. Speaking about my direct realization. About Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, you see, one devotee, that is another case. One devotee, he was very angry with his Guru Varga. He has done nothing. Only that Guru Varga chasing him. Hey, why you are going to our field to beg for rice and this, that? He said, same mod, Devananda Gaudiya mod, same mod. I am going for Acharya, Gurudev. So your field is different, I don't know. I go there. Why you are doing? Don't go there. Then he speak very heavily. Naturally. For my Gurudev I gone there, not for me. Same mod, he is Acharya. Come on. He is speaking heavily against me. Then the information came to Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj came to know that this my sevak speaking heavily against one of my godbrother. He is speaking, who give you permission? Who give you permission? Who give you permission to speak against my godbrother? Maharaj, he is chasing me this way. Yes, he can do. Why you are speaking anything against my godbrother? Go away from me. I don't like to take any seva from you. He said, oh my God, I was doing for you. I cannot take seva from you. You see the mood of a pure Vaishnava. At present we are saying, all my Guru Varga are useless. Don't go there. It's the mood of Vaishnava. You learn. Learn. Before leaving this body, you will have to get all Siddhanta Vichar. Or you cannot come out successful. Whatever Guru you take. Yahi vatai rijitam jesam samme sitam manaha. This life, when you have enough power, you will have to do everything. When you get old, cannot do. Do your bhajan. So, again I want to remind you. Nate vidu swartha gotimihi vishnum durasaya je vahira samani andhayatandair paniyamanam teyo pisichatandamurudam nivadhya vancha kalpaturvasya kipasandhi bhavaja. Patitanang Pavanam Vaishnav Bhyo Namo. Any question? No? All question I am giving answer. No question left in your life. This is the chadar of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. This chadar, I am carrying it for 8-10 years. I have also the chadar of Bhakti Vala Tithya Goswami Maharaj. Those Vaishnavas they are giving me. They know I am beggar, I have nothing. So they are giving me. Okay, you can take.